Welcome back to the channel, everybody. In today's video, we're gonna be doing some work on my Falcon here behind me. We're gonna take a break from the Honda. I have some parts that are on the way. They were supposed to be delivered yesterday, but they got delivered to the wrong house. So I'm in the process of getting that all figured out. So if you guys saw on a previous video, maybe two videos ago at this point, I mentioned on the Falcon, I'm having some rocker arm issues, and I'm gonna be trying to figure that out today, see what's going on. So, it sounds like it's coming from the passenger side. So I'm gonna take off the passenger side. I'm gonna check the rockers. I have some other ones to replace it with, and we're gonna go from there. Valve cover off. We got that one right here. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be that. I don't think it's supposed to be that way. I think that's a little too much play. But we're gonna start with that one first. We're gonna take that one apart and see what it looks like.
That doesn't look good.
Let me see.
Look at that guide plate. It's like...
Let me take it.
We gotta change that guide plate. Look at it. Look at the hole. See that? Why is it like that? It looks like it's all deformed and crushed.
Let's take it off and put another one. The other spring is up too, so you could do both of those. Let's change that thing. That don't look right.
Mm-hmm. Taking off that first rocker arm, looking at that guide plate. That guide plate's all deformed and doesn't look good at all.
I don't think it's called a guide plate.
Well, what would it be called?
I don't know. That's where the pedestal sits.
Yeah. I don't know what that's called. If you know what it is, leave a comment. We're going to take the other one off and we're going to change it and check that other rocker. Actually looks okay.
We don't know what we saw.
Yeah, it'll look really weird. So this is the old rocker. We're gonna replace it. I have a bunch of extra ones here. And I'm gonna use the same one that came out. And inside the rocker arm, it has these grooves. You can see the grooves in there. And the fulcrum has the same grooves. I'm gonna match the grooves so that they're the same. So when I put the rock arms back in, I am gonna put some anti-seize, little anti-seize on the bolt, because these are aluminum heads. That should be good enough.
Yeah. That'd be good, yes. There goes the mailman.
Ouch. And I wanna spin the engine over to check that first one.
Okay.
Push
I'm gonna walk out and get the mail.
So this one was the one that I'm replacing. Took it out of the cleaner, sprayed it down, but it's kind of dry, so I'm gonna put some oil in it. Don't want to have it be dry when it starts up. Put some oil in there. Should be good to go now. Nice. So now that I have the rockers, you know, they're finger tight. Now I'm gonna snug them down with the regular ratchet and then I'm gonna torque them to 25 foot-pounds. Doing this always makes me nervous.
I know. Using a torque wrench always makes me nervous because you feel like you're overdoing it.
Nice. I didn't do them real tight with the rubber ratchet, just hardly anything, just to get them started, you know? See if we can go back. That one sweep. You wanna come give it the wiggle test? You're not even in the camera there. Oh, there you are.
Hello. Look at that.
Why is it like that?
I don't know. Why does that do that? Maybe that's what keeps it from... Maybe that's okay. You know, that's where the space is going to be. Oil. These have oil in them.
Yeah.
That really not, you know, that just has a little bit for assembly. But see, even the one you just put in, they both do it.
Little bit?
Yeah, they both do it. That's okay. These ones are nice and pumped up right now. You could check the torque and make sure it's at the right torque spec still. You know, you could check that one and you could check this one. Then you could turn the motor and then do the other three.
Just to make sure they're at that 25?
Yeah.
I can do that.
So you could check this one and you can check this one over here. You can just see that it's up over one.
Yeah. Okay, cool. That's at 25. Drop the hair in the engine. Check this one, that's up. Yeah, good. 25. Ready. Let's just check them all, make sure they're all at. That one's good. That one's good. They're not turning. Maybe it's just a teeny, teeny bit, if anything. Check this one.
And you're good.
Double check these two here. Yep. 25 pounds.
Put it back together. Put oil on those two back ones. Put it back together. Are you going to check this side or no?
Yeah, I might as well, right?
Just at least you could do is
torque them down. Make sure they're wiggling around.
So I'm going to pour a little bit of oil right on top of the rocker arm just because, just to be safe. Some of the cheap 1040 conventional that we bought for the Honda. I run 1040 in this. same thing on this side. I'm gonna have my dad give the rocker arms a little bit of a wiggle. It's not a scientific test or anything like that. So I'm gonna double check the torque on these, is make sure that they're still at 25 pounds, and probably gonna leave it alone because the passenger side was the one that was making noise, the driver's side wasn't.
Let me see the green light real quick.
You spotted something interesting?
Maybe, yeah. Not even sure it matters, but.
What do you see?
Look how this push rod touches the cylinder head. What are you doing?
Pushing the whole car back.
Trying to look. I got my foot on it.
Oh yeah, look at that, huh?
That could be ding, 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 ding.
That could be a problem. Yeah, is that the only one?
No, this one's almost touching too. That's touching the cylinder head. That's not supposed to touch. That's why small block Chevys or guide plates, but that could mean that hole in the cylinder head is not cut up high enough, because the push rod needs to be here.
Yeah.
So that hole might need to be clearanced on the cylinder head.
My dad has found some news here. He's talking about this one.
Down in here.
Yeah,
that rocker arm, push rod, is touching the top of the cylinder head there, right inside that hole in that opening. It's not supposed to touch that.
Yeah, that's a big no-no.
That could be a clearance issue right there, and every time that thing is on there, it's tapping it. Tap, 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 tap.
Metal shavings in the oil.
It might not metal shave it, but it's aluminum. It might just slide up and down on there, but at the end of the day, it's not supposed to be touching it. And that other one back, this one's kind of close too. This one's, they're really close. That one's actually touching. This back one here, it looks like it's touching also.
Right here is where the push rod is rubbing the head. That does not make me happy, that's for sure.
If you didn't catch our last video, I'll leave a link in the description so you guys can go and check that out. Stay tuned for more videos, because as you can tell, we have quite a few things to get done around here with the Falcon and the Honda. All right, guys, that's going to be on this video. Thanks for watching. Leave your comments down below what you think about the Falcon, the problem that we're having with the push rod rubbing up against the head. That's definitely not right. We got to fix that. I've been feeling like this thing just hasn't really been running right for a little while. It's been sitting here for the past 3 months because of that issue. And we've been busy working on the Honda, been busy with work. So it's just been kind of been put off. But with the parts being delivered to the wrong house for the Honda, I was like, okay, I'm going to get jump on the Falcon today. Good thing I did to figure out that issue, because I don't want to be driving it around with those push rods rubbing up against the head. That's not a good thing. But make sure you guys comment, like, and subscribe. Turn on the bell. And that's going to be the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one.